this video will take you through how to check your similarity report in Turnitin. It will also explain how to interpret the information presented in your similarity report. If you have any questions about the information in your similarity report, which are not covered in this video, you can ask your lecturers or your personal tutor for help. Step 1. Select assessment and marks in your module. Step 2. Scroll down the page to the assessment submission points folder. Step 3. Select view complete on the submission point where you submitted your work. Step 4. When your similarity report is available, a percentage number will be shown. Select the number to access your report. Step 5. In the Turnitin Feedback Studio, a number will be shown on the right-hand side of your work. Select the number to access your match overview. Let's look at the match overview together in detail. The first thing I will say is that 10% is not a high match, but it is important not to think of the match number as good or bad. So even if the percentage number is shown as green in the submission point, it could still be made up of matched text that needs to be revised or removed. What we need to look at are the matches that make up that 10%. To give you an example, if you see a series of matches of 2% or less making up your 10%, then that is an indication of a healthy similarity report. In this example, we should pay close attention to the two matches of 4% each. Each of these matches needs to be checked. We also need to consider these matches in relation to the length of the paper. This paper is close to being 2,000 words long, so a 4% match is about 80 words. To help with this process, be on the lookout for highlighted blocks of text, as these indicate a high match section. If any matches you find are quotations, you need to check that you have correctly cited the source of the quotation according to the referencing style used in your school. It is worth noting that certain types of assignments will have higher match percentages than others. So, for example, an assignment where you are given a document template to use, or another example would be an evaluative report where you are asked to analyse a text sample or a public document. Also, you may be wondering why the total of the percentage matches shown is 11%, not 10%. This is because there may be some overlap between the matches found that make up that 10%. To be clear, the percentage here is not a mark or grade, but it is provided to help you identify potential plagiarism. So plagiarism is copying someone else's work and presenting it as your own. Another potential issue that Turnitin will find is collusion, working with someone else to present their work or work you have produced together as your own. This example submission has been intentionally created to show plagiarism and collusion issues. If this were my actual work, I would need to review and then fix each of the issues by going back to my original Word document. Having edited and saved my original document, I would then need to resubmit it prior to the deadline. Let's look at match number 1 on the list in more detail by clicking on it. Looking at this match, I can see that it is matching to another student's work at the university. I cannot see any detailed information about the match, such as whose work it is or the text being matched. This information is not available for privacy reasons. This piece of matched text is an example of collusion. So in this scenario, I asked a friend in the year above me if I could look at their essay. I copy and pasted some of their essay into my notes. This was unintentional collusion, but I have still copied their work and presented it as my own here. So I need to remove this section and revisit my own research for this assignment, asking myself, what research have I done for this assignment? Am I presenting my own research in this assignment or someone else's? I'm going to need to rewrite at least this section of my assignment, possibly even more if I've not done the research to back up what I am writing. To summarise, each assignment needs to be based on your own original thinking and your own research, which should be supported by citing articles, peer-reviewed publications, books, and carefully checked web content along the way. So I can get back to the main list by pressing the arrow there at the top left. And we will now move on to the second match, which is a more conventional example of plagiarism, where I found some really good content in a journal that I wanted to include in my essay, but I've made three key mistakes here. One is I haven't included the text in quotation marks that I am quoting from this journal article. I also haven't correctly cited that content, so there's no indication as to where I got this content from. And finally, this is a very long quote. It is a paragraph long, which may not be allowed according to the referencing style guide which is used in your school. So do be sure to refer to the guidance provided. You can seek advice on this from your lecturers, your personal tutor, and the library. Moving on to the third match. This is an example of where I have tried to paraphrase some content from a website. Paraphrasing is a way of explaining a concept or idea in your own words. In this example, however, I have retained the structure of the original text and only changed a few words here or there by selecting words that mean the same thing. So I really need to rewrite this myself, completely in my own words and with fresh sentence structure. Use of paraphrasing is allowed, but you still need to cite the original source of the concept or idea. Otherwise, if you present it as your own work without explaining the source, that would be plagiarism. Moving on to the fourth match, which is a very small match. If we click on that, we will see that it is matching to the title of a book, which is in italics, and the year for the book is included, and the author is also referenced in that sentence. So that is probably okay, as long as it matches with the style guide that's used in our school, we're good to go, and we just need to go down to our reference section and make sure that the book is also included there. So I can see it is included there. It is a good excuse, though, for us to look at the references, and I can see a mistake there in that those last two books should have italicized titles. So I am going to need to go back and review that in my original Word document. So there are a couple more things to tell you about. You can access a full list of sources from the button that looks a bit like a bar chart. So this is less helpful than the match overview, but it does give you full detail. You can access some filters and settings using the button that looks like a funnel. You can use the settings here to do things like exclude quotes. So if you change the settings in this area, you need to press apply changes below, and it may change the overall similarity report score, as in the percentage. And these options can be helpful if you want to look in detail at specific matches in your paper. To summarise our advice, work through the information in your report and make changes in your original document to prevent any unintended plagiarism or collusion. Ask for help interpreting your similarity report if you need it. Try not to panic and make sure you leave enough time to work on this important part of the submission writing and editorial process. Step 6. Having edited your work in the original document and saved it, you can then resubmit it and see your new similarity report score, usually after a few minutes. If you have any technical issues with your similarity report, for example, it does not process within 12 hours of submission and it is your first, second, or third submission attempt, then contact the Information Services Service Desk for assistance. You can email them at servicedesk@brighton.ac.uk or call them at 01273 644444. Thanks for watching.